Oh no, terrifying legendary Lord Nakari is coming to get us. Whatever will we do? Who will save us from this Oh, okay, never mind. I guess that problem solved in the space of about 5 seconds then. But who is our savior from this terrifying beast? Who is the hero that has deleted the almighty Nakari?
It's 2 units of goblins. What?
Maybe you thought that was easy though, because Nakari hasn't got any armor on. Well, how about Scarbrand then? He's got full health. How long can he survive the Chaos Dwarf onslaught? Also, not very long. 5 to 10 seconds, if he's lucky, before he starts stumbling around like your drunken aunt at a birthday party. And down she goes. One more then, here's Lord Mazdamundi. Full health. He's got tons of armor. He's got tons of health. Surely he can survive one volley from Chaos Dwarf units.
Nope.
Full health to zero in under 5 seconds, pretty much. And here's the cheeky dwarf mostly responsible. The Sorcerer Prophet Lord. You see, he has a lot of weaknesses to fire that he can stack. He has flammable on his ranged attack. So you use that first of all. There's 20% weakness to fire to whatever you're aiming at. Then you've also got Kindle Flame if you use a fire spell. So that can stack another 20%. So there's 40% right there. And then you've got the big boy ability, the Vial of Hashut, giving a weakness to fire of 60%. So all in all, 100% weakness to fire damage. So essentially 200% damage for your units, if you can time it well. It also reduces armor by 40, so that's just going to help you do even more damage. To show you the Scarbrand example here, we've got our Sorcerer Prophet. I've hit Scarbrand with his Flare ranged attack to light him up and give him that 20% first of all. I'm also using blunderbusses in this example who don't have fire damage, so we need to give it to them with Flaming Sword of Ruin, which will also set off Kindle Flame. And then we use the Vial of Hashut, and that'll give us that 100% weakness to fire, as seen down here. And then when he gets hit by the ranged attack from the blunderbusses, it's bye-bye Scarbrand. Although in this example, I didn't time it terribly well as Kindle Flame ran out a bit early, but still, an 80% weakness to fire left Scarbrand absolutely destroyed. That minus 40 armor really helping here as well. Now those aren't the only weaknesses to fire that this faction can employ. Also, the Lore of Hashut has a spell Ash Storm, which gives a 20% weakness to fire, so you could bring that along. And then there's the matter of units that already have a weakness to fire, like old Durthu here as a woody tree unit. He has a weakness to fire of 25% by default. Does that stack with the 100%? Can we get 125%, maybe even 145% with Ash Storm as well? Well, let's find out. Durthu very kindly waiting around to be our test subject. In comes Ashstorm from the Lore of Hashut, so that's a 20% weakness to fire right there. Laying down Flaming Sword of Ruin, so that's 20% from Kindle Flame. It doesn't appear on the character for some reason. There you go again, yep. They're pretty bad shots with that flare attack, but they got him. Vial of Hashut gone on. Let's see how many weaknesses to fire old Durthu has. I think Kindle Flame has worn off because they kept missing with the flammable attack, but they've still got 100% on him right now, plus the 25%. In theory, this should be 125%, but it's only 100. So it seems that there is a cap limiting to a 100% fire weakness, which is probably for the best, let's be honest. But how well does Durthu survive this 100% weakness to fire? Not very well. Poor Dewey. Poor Doodoo. He's going down. Down he goes. So that's the full maximum of this capability with the Sorcerer Prophet, but without him, this is considerably less, but still enough to be very useful from other characters and units that can also inflict weaknesses to fire, such as the Demon Smith. If you bring him with the Lore of Hashut, he's got Ash Storm and also that same ranged attack, so that's flammable, so there's 40% from him, or if you bring the fire version, you've got Kindle Flame instead, so still 40%. Then you've got the Oglekan's Wolf Boys. They also have flammable on their ranged attack, so they can apply a 20%. Astragoth, also good for this. He can stack up to 60% fire weakness. As he does have fire spells, he'll get Kindle Flame when he uses one. His Black Hammer of Hashut will imbue him with flammable, so that's another 20%, so that's 40. And then he also has the spell Ash Storm as well, so that's the 60. And if you stack all that up together, we can get some similar massive damage boosts, although not quite as much as that Sorcerer Prophet with the 80 or 100%. But still, very nice. As we see here with Kugath, we're going to rip about half his health off in one volley. Not to mention you've got Astragoth in there doing his melee attack, which is also going to be boosted because that does have fire damage as well. And here's the same thing on Archaon. But in this case, I am using mostly lords, and here's a smaller lord to show you that it absolutely destroys a smaller lord. They don't have to be a big single entity, but it'll work on any unit, really. And once you've stacked those weakness to fire penalties from the sources I've just shown you, you can use any of the many fire damage units from this army. to absolutely destroy all sorts of stuff. Here's Imric, and I'm going to use, in this case, the blasting charges from the Iron Swarm. In this case, I'm using the Flammable from the ranged attack, Ash Storm, and the Vial of Hashut. And here comes the blasting charges. How well do they destroy our boy Imric? Pretty damn well. There's half his health gone in one volley. And what's more, Imric has a fire resistance. So I think it's maybe like 25 or 35%. He's reducing our damage by that, but he's still getting absolutely pounded. Disgusting. What about old man Manfred on his mount being blasted by fire glaives with an 80% weakness to fire just from the Sorcerer Prophet? As we can see, he's on his way to being double dead very damn quickly. And the nice thing about units like the fire glaive and the goblin archers with fire, you don't have to add on the fire like you do with blunderbusses, so they're good from that perspective. Although the blunderbusses are arguably the best unit for this, as their damage output is very quick, it's huge, it's armor piercing, they do a lot of work very quickly, but you do need to imbue them with fire. That can come from Flaming Sword of Ruin, like we did earlier, or from the Infernal Castellan, who has this ability Breath of Hatred, which will imbue fire damage to an area. Also Armor Sundering, which helps. So a couple of options. Here's another random example of a combination you could have. I've got the Wolf Boys with their flammable trait. That's going to give you a flammable that will at least land a bit more reliably than the Sorcerer Prophet's shot. I've also got the Demon's Tongue, the Regiment of Renown Iron Demon, with its flamethrowers. Which, honestly, is a little underwhelming. The Iron Demons seem like they need some adjustments, to be honest. But we're going to put the Vial of Hashut on Mazdamundi here and then unload all of this into there. Somebody else is shooting him as well in the distance. I've got a few units in this test. But you can see the Iron Demon doing a kind of disappointing amount of damage there. We've got the Wolf Boys and their arrows will be doing damage as well as adding flammable. But it's worth noting as well that a weakness to fire penalty can only stack if it's a different kind. So, for example, if you've got two lots of flammable, like I do here, I've got it from the Sorcerer Lord and also from the Wolf Boys. But I can only apply one count of flammable. It won't stack if it's the same type. Same with like Kindle Flame. If I brought two fire sorcerers and used two fire spells at the same time to set off Kindle Flame twice, it would still only apply one lot of Kindle Flame. Mazdamundi going away pretty quick here, so this random combination still works pretty well. And finally, how about an example with some infantry? The Immortals here. We saw this fight the other day in my Who's the Best video versus Chosen of Nurgle. And we saw that it's a pretty close fight between these two, so it could go either way normally. But if we apply the 80% weakness to fire to the Chosen of Nurgle, how much will it help out the Immortals in winning this fight? Well, it turns out pretty damn well, as it allows the Immortals to win this fight with still about half of their health left, whereas if the Chosen didn't have the weakness to fire, they probably would have been down to about one-tenth of their health left, if they even managed to win. So it's helping in all situations all across the enemy army. Any unit that you specifically want to take out, you can hit it with loads of weaknesses to fire, stack them all up, and then use any of these many fire units to get into them and do some serious damage. And you can use any of the units you see here. They've all got fire attacks. There's plenty of it in this army. They just need to be set up by the few units in the army that are able to inflict weaknesses to fire. And in particular, we can get some pretty disgusting effects from this, from the Sorcerer Prophet with the Vial of Hashut. 80%, 100% weakness to fire, then use maybe blunderbusses or fire glaives, and you will destroy anything very, very quickly. But there we go. I hope you've enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all the patrons who support this channel. I will see you in the future.